Good morning. Welcome to worship on this Pentecost Sunday. Before we get started, I just want to give you directions as to your waivers, your sticks with the ribbon. This is Pentecost Sunday where we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit. So throughout our service, when you hear the word Spirit, you can wave them, or whenever the Spirit moves you to wave it, wave it. We want to see them flying, so everyone will know that the Holy Spirit is among us today. Please rise as you are able. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ, for these waters where you make us new, leading us from death to life, from tears to joy. We bless you, risen Christ, that your Spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of rebirth. Like rains to our thirsting earth, like streams that revive our souls, like cups of cool water shared with strangers. Breathe your peace on your church when we hide in fear. Clothe us with your mercy and forgiveness. Send us companions on our journey as we share your life. Make us one risen Christ. Cleanse our hearts. Shower us with light. To you be given all praise with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God, now and forever. Amen. To bear the cross, is the day that the Lord has made. Christ has been raised from death to new life. Christ is risen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Mighty God, you breathe life into our bones, and your Spirit brings truth to the world. Send us this Spirit, transform us by your truth, and give us language to proclaim your gospel through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. You may be seated for the reading. A reading from Acts. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them the ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthian, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 104. How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Prince of sea, great and wide, with his swarms too many to number, living things both small and great.
There go the ships,
to and fro, and Leviathan, which you made for the sport of it.
And look to you to give them their food in due season.
You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things.
When you hide your face, they are terrified. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust.
You send forth your spirit, and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. O Lord, rejoice in all your works.
You look at the earth and it trembles. You touch the mountains and they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being.
May these words of mine please God. I will rejoice in the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful. Kindle us in the fire of your love. The Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, when the Advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify because you have been with me from the beginning. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you ask me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because they do not believe me. About righteousness, because I'm going to the Father, and you will see me no longer. About judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. You need to see it. So this morning we celebrate Pentecost, one of our important feast days of our year. On Christmas we celebrate God the Father giving us the Son, Jesus, who would bear God's divinity while taking on human form and living as we do. On Easter we celebrated Jesus, God's Son, victorious over sin and evil and death, his dying and rising for us. For our salvation, so that we might have eternal life. On Pentecost, we celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit, the third part of our Trinity. Before Jesus ascended to heaven, he promised that he would send an advocate, a presence that would be in our corner at all times, helping, guiding, comforting, so that we are never out of God's sight, never alone. God will be with us till the end of the age. In a few minutes, we'll invite four of our young men forward to affirm their baptism. They will state for themselves the promises that their parents made on their behalf when they were first brought to the waters of baptism. I will place my hands on their head and ask God to stir up the spirit in them, to equip them to move forward in their life of faith as full members of our congregation. God's claim on them will be reaffirmed as they enter into the next steps of their journey in faith. To be one with us as we gather today with our altar draped in red to the fire that the Holy Spirit ignites in us all, one body in Christ. The people gathered on that first Pentecost had traveled from different countries. They spoke many languages, and they misunderstood one another. Language can divide us. We tend to spend time with those who speak our same language, those with which we have something in common. There's a level of understanding that does not easily exist when we're with people of different languages as we try to communicate. Yet the Spirit came to them all on that Pentecost, and it changed them so that they were not all the same. God did not erase their differences. Instead, their differences were honored as part of God's diverse creation. God met them where they were, coming from all walks of life, all parts of the land, diverse, different, yet all equal in God's eyes, all beloved by God. The Spirit translated the gospel for them into one holy language of love. And with it came an understanding of God that had been missing, and a peace where it had not been before. The good news for us is that the work of the Holy Spirit is not done. Our world still needs help bridging divides between its people. We need God to keep reaching across differences that divide us. We have seen this play out time and time again as people around the world and right here in our own communities dwell more on what makes us different than what unites us. But the good news is that God is far from done with us. Pentecost continues to come. The Holy Spirit is still active today, teaching us how to love, care for each other, and find peace, the peace of Christ. The peace, or shalom, of the Lord is much more than a check-in halfway through our service. In Hebrew, the word shalom means completeness, completeness, wholeness, health, peace, welfare, safety, soundness, tranquility, prosperity, perfectness, fullness, rest, and harmony, and the absence of agitation or discord. The peace of the Lord is not something we do for ourselves. It's not under our control. The peace of the Lord is an active work by God in the Spirit. Our God, who bears our sins through His Son, restores us to wholeness, brings us to a place where we are safe, at peace, and not afraid. This is how we know the peace that Jesus leaves us with. God's Holy Spirit empowers us with its fruits, brings shalom, precious gifts that send us out into the world to share that peace with others. Empowered by the Spirit, we know that we are not alone. God is with us, guiding, leading, loving, through all the joys and the sorrows that come our way. This is the promise of Pentecost, that God promises we're not alone. Now, we've all been given the ability to understand the gospel, and now we too can speak, and our voices can spread the gospel of understanding through Jesus' message of love and salvation to all the ends of the earth. Sounds wonderful, doesn't it? Well, a word of caution is needed, because like it or not, when the Spirit gets a hold of us, when we give ourselves over and let the Spirit take us where we want to go, watch out, because things can get a little bit crazy and a bit uncomfortable. For God's Spirit does not like things to stay the same. It thrives on action and change. It is the original out-of-the-box game changer. The Spirit takes us out of our comfort zones and shakes us up. We're challenged to get moving to make a difference. Mostly we're challenged to be the church that God desires us to be. And please understand that being the church doesn't mean sitting in the same pew you always have and doing all the same things you've done for years. Being the church usually means leaving this building to be in the world where God needs us to be. Are you ready? Because all this means stepping out of our comfort zones, listening to where God is calling you. This congregation is in a very exciting point in our life cycle. Transitions can be times of uncertainty, but they are also wonderful times of opportunity. Opportunities to look at our history, our community, to evaluate where we are now, what's working, what could use a little tweaking, and what maybe would be best left in the past. And then to look around at what opportunities lie ahead. New leaders, new ministries, new outreach, new partnerships. The possibilities are endless. I urge you all to get involved as we enter into the collaboration process with our brothers and sisters at Gloria Dame King of Kings. Reach out to a member of the team to ask questions, address concerns, offer assistance. Let the Holy Spirit take hold of you and fill you with hope and inspiration. The church on that first Pentecost was just being born. They learned how to gather as a community, how to be the church of that day as they went along. They made mistakes, sure, but they learned and grew together, becoming stronger by the day. Christians have been learning how to do this church thing ever since then. But the one thing that was true on that first day that remains true today, if you truly want to be the follower of Christ that Jesus asked us to be, then buckle your seatbelts, because once the Holy Spirit gets a hold of you, you will be on a ride of a lifetime, one that will stretch your idea of what church means. The Holy Spirit takes the wheel, asking us to come along for the ride, led by faith to follow our Creator, our Redeemer, and our guide into the richness and beauty of the world. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks and praise for the gift of your Holy Spirit. Send your Spirit flowing into this gathering and remind us that today is not just a festival of the church year where we wear red and have geraniums. Fill us with the power of the Holy Spirit that washes over us, grounding us with the power from on high. And help us know that your Spirit is present and accounted for on this Pentecost day in 2021. Enable us to hear your Spirit speak to each of us with words we need to hear. Awaken us to your will for this community. Give us the bold, fresh words to spread the gospel to a world that is hungry for its message. Dwell in us so that we do not allow your powerful Spirit to remain stuck in this place as we walk out the door to enter the world. Empower us to move forward into the future and serve in your world with joy and gladness. Amen.
Your leading, now we're leading.
In the body of Christ, who are making public affirmation of their baptism. I present Sean Patrick Burke. Sean William Harrisonitis. Daniel Walter Ryan. David Jones. Carl. Yeah, Daniel? Come on, front. Come on, front. Come around the front. Who desire to make public affirmation of their baptism. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for these brothers whom you have made your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called them to yourself. Enlighten them with the gifts of your spirit and nourish them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ. Amen. Parents and sponsors of the church, thank you for your ministry of encouragement and example of faith. You have now fulfilled the promises made at the time of your child's baptism. You have helped lead them to this day, to the opportunity to publicly speak the words of faith you first spoke for them, to seek the renewed blessing of baptism now by their own choice. I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? I invite the congregation to stand and renew your faith as well. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the dead. coming. You have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? One by one, please respond, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me. Assembly, people of God, do you promise to support these brothers and pray for them in their life of Christ?
And ask God to help and guide us.
Okay, let's move to Alana. She can go while we work.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth. Cleanse us from sin and raise us up to eternal life. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Sean William Heritonitis the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving. Give him patience and suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Sean Patrick Buck the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving. Give him patience and suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Daniel Walter Ryan the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Kyle David Jones the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience and suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Sean William Aronofsky. Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and you shall find it. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth. And to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Matthew 7. Sean Patrick Burke. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not rely on your own insight. Proverbs. Daniel Walter Ryan. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. 1 Corinthians. child, David Jones. I can do everything with Christ who gives me strength. Philippians.
I now ask you to stand and face the congregation.
Let us rejoice with these brothers in Christ.
We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. Let us come together. Baptism with us. May we turn to you. Okay, we turn to you. You may be seated.
Alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Gracious God, you give the Holy Spirit to your church, filling it with many and varied gifts. In the church throughout the world, strengthen us in our visioning and dreaming, that it may discover anew the Spirit's creative work. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of life, your mighty works are too numerous to count. The earth is full of your creatures, living things, both great and small. Open your hand and give them the necessities of this life. Send your fresh spirit over the face of the earth. Hear us, O Lord.
Your mercy is great.
God of nations, at the sound of the rushing wind, people speaking different languages proclaimed and heard together your deeds of power. Fill the leaders of nations with your Holy Spirit, so that they exercise your gracious will in the lives of people. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of faithfulness, you tend to the needs of your people, even the size of our heart. Hear those who cry out to you in distress. Restore to wholeness all who are in any need this day, especially Stephen, Mike, Peter, Bruce, Christina, Jackie, Steve, Teresa, Carol, Aaron, Philip, George, Charlie, Betty, Ralph, Phoebe, Jimmy, Barbara, Lynn, Kim, Judy, and those we named silently or aloud. Hear us, O God. God of love, fill this congregation, St. Peter's, with gratitude for the gifts we have received from you. Renew our ministries, heal our divisions, and open us to the needs of our neighbors. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of hope, those who have died in you raise their eternal song of praise. We give you thanks for the many gifts of your people and rejoice in the witness of your saints. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share Christ's peace. Stewardship is about love. Let us pray. God of love, you call us beloved children and welcome us to your table. Receive our lives and the gifts we offer. Abide with us and send us in service to a suffering world for the sake of your beloved child, Jesus Christ. Amen. Now I invite you to rise as you're able and take out the communion chalice that you were got on the way in. If you did not get one, please raise your hand and an usher will bring one to you. Okay.
Find us together, Lord, find us together with glory, that cannot be broken. Find us together, Lord, find us together, Lord, find us together in love. There is only one God, there is only one King. Find us together, Lord, find us together with Lord, that cannot be broken. Find us together, Lord, find us together, Lord, find us together in love. You are the family of God. You are the promise divine. You find us together, Lord, find us together with cords that cannot be broken. Find us together, Lord, find us together, Lord, find us together in love.
Holy God, mighty Lord, gracious Father, endless is your mercy and eternal your reign. You have filled all creation with light and life. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. We praise you for the grace shown to your people in every age. The promise to Israel, the rescue from Egypt, the gift of the promised land, the words of the prophets, and at the end of all the ages, the gift of your Son, who proclaimed the good news in word and deed, and was obedient to your will, even to giving his life. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks. Gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, O God, with this bread and cup, we remember the life our Lord offered for us, and believing the witness of his resurrection, we await his coming in power to share with us the great and promised feast. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. send now, we pray, your Holy Spirit, that we who share in Christ's body and blood may live to the praise of your glory and receive our inheritance with all your saints in light. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Join our prayers with those of your servants of every time and every place, and unite them with the ceaseless petitions of our great High Priest, until he comes as victorious Lord of all. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Gathered into one, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The risen Christ invites us to this table. Come, eat, and be satisfied. Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all people. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you for joining us today on this wonderful celebration day. A reminder that we are continuing to follow our current guidelines of mask wearing and spacing, even though I know the CDC has relaxed some of its guidelines. We are preferring to do a little bit of wait and see for a couple weeks. We want to get past the Memorial Day holiday and make sure that there's no spread that comes after that, because our first and foremost priority is to keep all of you safe and protect the most vulnerable and let them feel safe when they come here. So look towards the middle of June. If all looks well, then we will most likely relax the mask mandate. But until then, we please ask you to continue to follow social distancing and the mask requirements as before, just to err on the side of safety and make it safe for everyone to enter our doors. We are looking to see whether anyone is interested in a vacation Bible school this year. So please look in on your blue sheet. There are a couple different options we've come up with. Please speak to either Lori Haddock or myself, because we want to know if there's any interest in a Bible school this summer and to go forward with that. Our coffee hour continues. I believe there might be refreshments outside today. I don't see Karen. In either case, we continue to have a virtual coffee hour, and the Zoom link is here. We have new St. Peter's magnets, so if you have not gotten one, they are on the table on your right. As you exit, please take one to your car to help us advertise St. Peter's to the community. Our annual meeting is coming up in 2 weeks. On June 6th, we will gather here immediately after worship. It will also be on live stream, hopefully, on Zoom. So please join us for that. We want to update you on everything that's going on, and we have to vote our council members in. Our Bible study continues on Wednesdays at 1 o'clock. And thank you so much for everyone that donated animal food in the last month. I packed up the confirmation kids helped me pack up the car last Sunday, and I brought a car full of wonderful items over to Helping Hands Rescue Mission, and they were thrilled beyond belief that there was so much there. They were very grateful that their clients can now have some food for their furry friends. What else? If you purchased a geranium in honor or memory of someone and you would like to take it with you after the service, we invite you to do that. Otherwise, they will stay here for another couple weeks to grace our sanctuary. Are there any other announcements? Okay, please rise. May our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus, the God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Please get out your spirit sticks as we sing our song.
The Spirit sends us forth to serve and grow in Jesus' name, to bring the tidings to the poor, the Savior to proclaim. I go to comfort those who mourn, where hope is dear to serve a dream and help the blind to see. So we go to be the hands of Christ to gather joy and peace.
Thank you.